of Moses and the literal interpretation of the commandment regarding the Sabbath, the people judged the Lord Jesus Christ as a breaker of the law of Moses. He broke the law of Moses, and they conspired to kill him. So the Lord today is telling them, what I did actually, I fulfilled the law of Moses. Because Sabbath, which means rest, means actually to give rest to the people. So if I healed a person in the Sabbath, I did not break the law of Moses, but I actually fulfilled the law of Moses. And he concluded by saying, do not judge according to appearance, but judge with righteous judgment. And the word righteous judgment from the word right. So he is asking them to make a right judgment. If we analyze how Israel judged the Lord Jesus Christ and condemned him to death, we will find, number one, they judged according to the appearance, without understanding. They perceived him as one who breaks the law of Moses, without understanding the real meaning of the law of Moses. Also, they judged according to emotions. For example, on Sunday, on Hosanna Sunday, Palm Sunday, the people actually were charged with emotion that this is the King of Israel. So received him and said, Hosanna in the highest, this is the King of Israel. 6 days later, on Friday, when they were charged with emotions against the Lord Jesus Christ, they changed their judgment and they cried before Pontius Pilate, crucify him, crucify him. Also, the people were driven by the opinion of the multitude. If the crowd said Jesus is a good person, then everybody will say he is a good person. And they would say, Hosanna in the highest, this is the King of Israel. If the crowd said, no, he is a bad person and deserved to die, then we would say, crucify him, crucify him. So the Lord is asking us, do not judge according to appearance, but judge with righteous judgment. And actually, every day we make choices. Every day we make judgment. So the question, how to make a righteous judgment? Sometimes when we make a wrong choice, or when we make a wrong judgment, we can suffer from this choice or judgment the rest of my life. And some choices or judgment will not only affect the rest of our life here on earth, but it can risk our eternal salvation. So the question here, how to make a righteous judgment? First advice here, do not make any judgment before praying and asking the Lord. Joshua in the Old Testament, after he defeated Jericho and Ai, people from Gibeon who were living among the Israelites came with wearing old clothes to pretend that they came from a very, very, very far country. And they met Joshua and they lied to him and they told him, we came from a very far country, although they were living in their midst, and asked Joshua to make a peace and treaty with them. And they told him, and we will serve you all the rest of our life. And Joshua, without praying and without asking God, he made peace and treaty with them. And then later on, he discovered that these people were living in their midst, and they deceived him. We read in Joshua chapter 9 and verse 14, then the men of Israel took some of their provisions of the Gibeons, but they did not ask the counsel of the Lord. That's why they were deceived, because they made judgment without asking and without praying. Don't make a decision in your life. Don't make judgment in your life. Don't make a choice in your life unless you pray about it for enough time and you feel peace in heart. And you pray, some people, they pray, God, do my will. They ask God to do their will. This is not the prayer, but the prayer should be, thy will be done. What do you want me to do? What choice you want me to make? What decision you want me to make? Number two, how to make a righteous judgment. And the Lord said, do not judge according to the appearance. There is a story in the book of Acts, chapter 28, verse 5. After St. Paul and all the people who were with him in the boat were delivered from a big storm, they went actually to a small island, and they were very, very cold because they were fighting with the storm in the sea for long time. That's why they collected some wood and fire to actually warm themselves. When they collected the wood, there was a snake, and actually it caught the hand of St. Paul. So the people of the island made a judgment according to the appearance. All of them said about St. Paul, this is a wicked man. Even after he was delivered from the storm, the divine justice did not let him go unpunished. That's why the snake actually caught his hand. Few minutes later, they did not find him dying. Actually, he threw the snake in the fire, and nothing happened to him. So few minutes later, they said, this man is God. The snake did not hurt him. So in these two judgments, they made judgment according to the appearance. Sometimes, without studying the whole situation, without researching the whole situation, or without listening to the other opinion. For example, if you are helping family and you listen to one member of the family without listening to the other side, we are quick to make judgment. But most of the time, this judgment will be wrong. That's why the Lord told us, do not judge according to the appearance, but judge with righteous judgment. The third advice, do not make judgment while you are angry, because the anger of man does not meet the righteousness of God. When we are angry, we are emotional, and our judgment most of the time is wrong. In the Old Testament, there's a story about David. After David committed adultery and murder, then God sent Nathan to rebuke him. David was king, and Nathan was a prophet. So how can he confront and rebuke a king? So he made up a story. about a man who had a lot of sheep and herd. And there was a poor man, his neighbor, very poor, and he has only one goat. And when a guest came to the very rich man, he took the goat of this poor man by force and killed it and prepared it as a meal for the guest. David became very angry and he said, this man should be killed. Not knowing that Nathan was speaking about David himself, but in his anger and in his emotion, made a decision that this man should be killed without understanding or without investigating the whole issue. Sometimes people come and charge us with emotion against somebody, and then we become angry, and then we make a judgment against this person and say, no, I'm not going to talk to this person ever again. No, I will avoid him. Don't make any judgment while you are angry. Number four, don't make judgment under the influence of emotion. As I told you, the people of Israel on Hosanna Sunday, they said, this is the King of Israel, Hosanna in the highest, about Jesus Christ. On Friday, they said, crucify him, crucify him. Why? Because these two judgments were made under emotions. There are two factors in making choices and judgment. Heart and mind. If actually we submit to the influence of emotions, most of the time our judgment will be wrong. Emotions can be easily deceived. For example, if you are watching a movie and you know it's just a movie, it's not a real story, it's just a movie. Many times we get emotional, we cry, get angry. So movie that we know it is not real actually plays with our emotions. So many times we make wrong judgment, especially if we are under the influence of emotions. Some people come to us and manipulate us by crying, by their tears. And when we are manipulated by this, we make judgment. But at the end, we discover this judgment is a wrong judgment. Think with your mind and use your mind to make your choices and your judgment, not your emotions. Number five, don't make judgment to please people. St. Paul said in Galatians chapter 1, verse 10, if I please people, I am not a servant of Christ. Sometimes we choose to break the law of God in order just to please people. But the apostles refused to do this. St. Peter said, we ought to obey God more than men. When the Judaizers are those people who became Christian, but they want to force the law of Moses on the people. So when the Judaizers actually attacked St. Paul in order to force circumcision on the converts to Christianity, St. Paul responded to them, proving from the Old Testament and New Testament that circumcision is just a symbol, symbol of baptism, and there is no need of it right now because we have the baptism. And the first council of Jerusalem convened, as we read in Acts chapter 15 to solve this problem. And they were not under the influence of pleasing the people, but they did the will of God. Saint Athanasius, when Arius actually said Jesus is not God, and Arius was able actually to take the whole world with him. One time they said to Saint Athanasius, the whole world is against you. And he said, I am against the world. That's why we call him contramundum, against the world. So don't make judgment just to please the people. Make judgment or choices to do the will of God, not to please the people. And the last point, don't make judgment based on the opinion of the majority. In Exodus 23 and verse 2, we read, you shall not follow a crowd to do evil, nor shall you testify in a dispute so as to turn aside after many to pervert justice. Again, you shall not follow a crowd to do evil, nor shall you testify in a dispute so as to turn aside after many, to follow the many, to follow the crowd, to pervert justice. Sometimes we make judgment just because the crowd say so. Social media now brainwash the mind of many people. And many people just follow the social media blindly. Many times we cancel our mind and just we think like the crowd. There is a story in Acts chapter 19 in Ephesus, this great city. Ephesus, they were worshiping idols. And some people, silversmith, they were making idols of silver, and they are making big, big business and make good money out of it. So after St. Paul started to preach Christ, many people stopped worshiping idols and converted to Christianity. So whose business got affected? Silversmith. Because they are not making idols anymore. So a person named Demetrius started a uproar in Ephesus against St. Paul. And some people actually gathered without knowing what is the problem. And they were shouting without understanding the issue, as we read in Acts chapter 19, verse 28. It says, now when they heard this, they were full of wrath and cried out, saying, great is Diana of the Ephesians. But in verse 32, we read, some therefore cried one thing, and some another, for the assembly was confused, and most of them did not know why they had come together. So people just joined the crowd, attacked St. Paul, even without knowing why they were gathered together. They just followed the majority, followed the crowd. Don't make judgment based on the majority. Don't make judgment based on majority. So let's review the 6 points that I mentioned how to make righteous judgment. Number one, don't make judgment before asking the Lord. Number two, don't judge according to the appearance. Number three, Don't judge while you are angry. Number four, don't make judgment under the influence of emotions. Number five, don't make judgment just to please the people. And number six, don't make judgment under the influence of the majority. Ask the Lord to give you wisdom, to give you discernment, in order to make judgment according to the will of God. Glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.